Well, here we are again. Back on this Bioshock 2. On this fine Labor Day weekend. Hope y'all Labor Day been nice. I had to chase out some damn dogs. My neighbor went to get a tattoo, I believe, and she asked me to look after her dogs. Well, first of all, she has four dogs, all of them niggas big. I was told, you know, just give them water, food. She was only going for like one night. You know, shit was supposed to be simple. I was told to give them water, food, basic stuff. Well, I let them out the backyard. You know, I make sure her cat doesn't get out, because I was instructed to not let that happen, because if that nigga got out, that nigga's just gonna leave and not come back. Okay, so, you know, it's pretty simple so far. I let the cat out. I let the dogs out. You know, I close the door after them to make sure the cat doesn't get out. I turn around. Somehow, some way, these niggas didn't open up the gate. So, now they just out in the neighborhood. Well, at the time, I'm thinking it's no big deal. You know, I have a dog back at, well, my mom has a dog back at my home. And, you know, my mom, when she lets the dog out, it's not that big of a deal. You know, that nigga gonna come back to the back door no matter what. He know he can't live without us. Hold up, we about to listen to this right quick.
Eleanor is progressing brilliantly. My physical participation in her birth was minimized, of course. It is vital that I am unhindered by nature's crude bias. I will be, above all, her intellectual progenitor. Loyal not to her, but to the people she will ultimately save. But I admit, it is with some measure of pride that I review her marks in standard intelligence tests. As an agent of our beliefs, she may surpass even me.
Not that crazy bitch done talking. Where was I? Oh, yes. When we let our dog out, that nigga know to come back. He know what's up. Well, I let these niggas out. I take, you know, 2-3 steps toward them.
Welcome to Quiet Amusements. Insert your ticket now. Half price for children under 3.
I take a few steps for them. These niggas take the fuck off. I mean, they are gone. I try to run after them, but, you know, they're dogs, so their athleticism outclasses mine.
You're a rare old model, son. Alpha Series, I believe. Now, Rapture's full of scientific wonderments just like you. And if we can sell them to the world at my price, well, curing your condition ought to be a cakewalk. Once we find Eleanor, the sky's the limit.
This nigga sound like he trying to use my surrogate child to do some fucked up shit, but hey, what else is new? But as I was saying, these niggas, you know, they getting ghosts. I'm sitting there thinking, wow, I really fucked around and lost four dogs that I don't own. Ain't this bad a bitch? What's up with all this? Oh, okay. I'll take that. Thank you. But yes, I'm sitting like, damn, I really lost this female dogs. So, you know, I'm feeling pretty shitty right about now. I hop in my truck to try to go find him. Actually, found one of them. I had to drag him by his collar. Not drag, because he was coming along willingly, but you know how dogs are. So, I had to pull him by his collar to get him in my truck. So, I'm like, okay, I got one. Let me go find these other three niggas. Thankfully, they turned their ass around. Well, two of them were chasing each other. They brought their ass back to the house. And there's this, another one, Golden Retriever, I believe. He finally brought his ass back to the house, too. That was a very stressful moment in my life. I would say there's nothing like, fucking up somebody else stuff. Because you really don't have any way to explain to them. Like, I wanted to be like, you know, if I had to explain to her, I would want...
Can I come again, Mr. B?
Alright. It just, you know, could be very hard.
Jim Dandy, that'll get you in the park. But buying incinerate's gonna cost Adam. It's a sort of genetic goo that lets you rewrite whatever God gave you. The little sisters carry the stuff, as you may recall, so you'll need to locate one. I heard whispering near the El Dorado Lounge. Have a look.
But yeah, it would have just been... Ooh. It would have been awful, trying to explain to her that I, fucked around, lost all her dogs. Would have been even worse when them niggas got hit by a car or something. That would have been terrible. But yeah, that's how I spent my Labor Day. Other than recording this video. And killing these niggas. Light work. Hope y'all had a more stable Labor Day than I did. Hopefully y'all actually enjoy, you know, some barbecue, some good stuff. Had me some nice queso from Chipotle. That was my Labor Day lunch. Anyway, let's go see about finessing this little girl, getting this Adam. You know we're gonna have to kill a Big Daddy.
Welcome to Ryan Amusements.
Got a tonic. Let's go.
Please enjoy the park.
Andrew Ryan wakes one night while cruising the Atlantic in his steamliner, the Olympian. His sleep interrupted with a singular purpose. Here, he shouts to his crewmen as he wipes sleep from his eyes. Full stop. We begin building here.
Man, how the fuck them niggas build a city under the sea in like 1950? Like, how'd that work? Niggas is just getting the hang of building cities. Oh shit. Niggas just getting the hang of building cities above the sea. I mean, on land.
Refitted for heavy construction, the Olympian returns with a new cargo. A state-of-the-art submersible platform, nicknamed the Sinker, ferries supplies and workers to the sea floor, fathoms below.
Well, that explains something.
After initial supplies have been brought to the seafloor, the platform is permanently moored in the sediment. Massive iron girders are sunk hundreds of feet into the rock and silt. Below the platform, engineers work to overcome obstacles, such as diamond-hard rock, obstinate sea life, and unexpected coverage.
Busted pile of junk! You broke it, didn't you, Edna? Everything you touch turns to shit!
That's not nice.
You're mean, Roger. It was probably your clumsy, fat hands that loused it up.
Typical broad. Stay away from things you don't know nothing about.
I'm
denied
better than
the word of God. Not the blood of the sun.
Seems like everybody's on the go.
That was an abrupt
days.
End.
Everybody but
I
you.
Probably should have thought that out more.
You.
Yeah, I probably should have thought that out more. There's a better way to do things there. damn it. Thank you, sir. Thank you, bitch. We're pretty much in the quote-unquote open world part of Bioshock 2. It's more like one of those situations where you they kind of have like a hub world, or a hub, I should say. I'm gonna shut the fuck up now.
We lost another of the Alpha Series protectors today in testing. Somewhere outside the city limits, he simply vanished. For these men, Rapture has no walls. We must find a method of conditioning them against abandonment of the Little Sisters. Something physical, possibly even lethal. The lab aides are starting to call them Big Daddies. Perhaps there's some genius to that. Bonded pairs, connected by a love that kills.
But as you saw back there at the interesting. Okay, it's not what I thought it was. Back at the little Adam thing, where you could upgrade your gene stuff. excuse me. It costs money. Well, it costs Adam. Now, not 100% sure, because I haven't played the original Bioshock in years. But I'm pretty sure that in the original Bioshock, it was more like you just kind of found stuff. Like, you found the new, like, plasmids and stuff.
After the platform is secured, work progresses at an astounding rate. Designed to be the foundation of Rapture, workers toil around the clock to create the metropolis you see today.
The times may be unkind, but did you have to take our phone?
Your kind ain't welcome here.
Sorry to hear that.
Save me, old lord! I'm lost all the time!
Sit your dumb ass down! Oh. I thought she was singing at that. Tiptoe through the window. I thought she was singing that song. Oh shit. What the fuck? Damn, nigga, Sinclair is doing dirty shit on the table, huh? That's real interesting, Sinclair. That's real.
So, you think you're getting out of here? It won't go well. It won't go well at all. So, you think you're getting out of here?
Well, hopefully that fortune teller ain't right. Now what this bitch crying about? Damn it. Sit your dumb ass down. Okay, got some nice stuff in here. Okay.
I know the surface, Eleanor. I spent half a lifetime there, in service of the common good. But then, I heard my own words twisted by fat old men squatting over the embers of Hiroshima. Were the modern world a patient in my care, I would diagnose it suicidal. Moral duty on perhaps that point alone, joy. Andrew Ryan is correct. Rapture is deliverance. We are mere engines of self-interest. Together, we are the family. And through unity, we transcend the self.
We are community. Damn. Y'all kill my nigga Jack? Sir, I'll be on my way. You can go your own way. Go your own way. I mean, shit, really, I don't need all the ammo they're giving me.
Until you arrive, Father, I'm trapped here. Smuggling these gifts out is the most I can do to help.
We got an inside man. Mess with it. What you got for me?
In ethical psychiatry, we must account for
Eleanor Lamb speaking. Mum says I'm not to play with the other children because they're being raised on a diet of dog eat dog. I wanted to see these dog eaters. So I waited until Mum was gone and went out to find one. And guess what? The dog eaters wear human skins. It makes them look just like us.
That's strange. There's a little sister ahead. To get to Adam, you must deal with her big daddy first. He will not attack until you do, but prepare for a difficult fight. Man, these big daddies ain't shit. I'm about to beat the brakes off this nigga. Tate Merlot. Where is big bitch at? Need that. Thank you, sir.
Big Daddy won't bite until you do. But to get to Lil Sis, you gotta put the old boy down for good.
Dilly-dally, dumbass. Bring the action. Yes, nigga! Oh, shit. Yes, we fucking you up, son. Oh, shit. Now sit your dumbass down.
Take a breath, son. You did it.
Now, just let her ride on your shoulders and she'll trust you like her own daddy.
Fuck that nigga up.
I found one of those children at last. Filthy dress, all alone. I approached her, praying that it was my little girl. But she was gorging herself on blood from a corpse. It wasn't her. I stared, just reeling. And then that skinny, armored freak that took Cindy jumped me, shrieking like an animal. I escaped, but could Cindy have become one of those things? I've got to find her, now more than ever.
I feel for you, man. Oh, shit. What happened here?
Are we gonna be together again, Daddy?
I mean, shit. I mean, since your old dude died, might as well. Man, such an unfortunate situation. Come on. Come on, little one. Man, that's unfortunate.
We're in business. Now, there are corpses all over Rapture, and little dimples there can sniff out the atom on them. Find one.
Any individual is to create a tyrant. We must therefore eradicate tyranny at the genetic level to end sin itself. That is the family. That is our cause.
She's got a juicy one. But when she starts draining out the atom, the splicers will come running. Be ready before you set her down on that body.
Nigga, I'm ready.
That is a child of the family. Not a toy for you to exploit and discard. It is fitting that you expire here. One more forgotten curio in Ryan's shrine to the self.
Here they come. Keep the splicers off her now till she's finished, or they'll never give up the hunt.
Too?
Now you know the stakes, son. But a plasmid costs a bit more atom yet. Keep it up.
Picking food, scrap to eat. I'm just grateful Mother doesn't have to see anything.
I heard that.
Yeah, you can hear whatever the fuck you want to hear.
No use hiding. I know this estate like the back of my
hand. Uh-huh. Thank you, sir.
I told you about this one. Make him listen.
Adam is near.
She doesn't like you.
Girl. She's helping. Just kill that man. What the fuck? I don't know what you think this is, sir.
It's this way.
it's just you and me, Mr. Voice Recorder. You, me, in 1959. I wonder what the new year was. What? What was that? Something's happened. The lights are going out. Kids, stay in your sleeping bags. It's gonna be fine.
Shit. I've been so fucking engrossed, I've been forgetting to say shit. Might be. As I said before, Ryan.
He's a revelation.
What the fuck? Ryan, a good villain. He's one of them niggas, like, one of them people that's talk like he got his head up his ass half the time. Sinclair was in with Andrew Ryan. That's interesting. That's very interesting.
I've been rationing my supplies ever since the park got cut.
I do not hate you, Delta. Indeed, I care for you in equal measure to any other sentient creature. But I cannot sacrifice 1,000 of my children for one rebellious son.
But what if I'm the prodigal son? Oh, shit. I'm getting fucked up right now.
We've almost got enough Adam now. To get the rest, you'll have to take care of that little sister. There should be one of the air vents they favor in the workshop. Bring her down there.
Well, them areas, they kind of tough. I mean, I'm also trash at the game, so that probably helps. Well, let's get this, let's get this little sister to, fucking druggy. To this little vent. You know the ones they be crawling out of. Get behind that.
On the surface, the scientist invests the power of his mind in a single miraculous idea and naturally begins to rise above his fellows. But the parasites say no. Discovery must be regulated. It must be controlled. And finally, surrender. Strives to frame his ideals in an image, to challenge his audience and make his vision immortal. But the parasites say, no, your art must serve the cause. Your ideals endanger the people.
Hey, if y'all don't like me watching these things, you know, just let me know. I thought about saying that's just too damn bad, but I mean, you know, ultimately, I want y'all to enjoy this, so. If y'all really don't fuck with me watching these things, yeah, just let me know. I can just forego them. I like those little story tidbits, though, so that's why I watch them. Just give you a little bit of a glimpse inside the mind of Andrew Ryan. I'm supposed to go down here. Man, I didn't expect this little area to be this long at all. Hold on, I saw a remote hack dart. Okay.
Lacking its own ingenuity, the parasite fears the visionary. What it cannot plagiarize, it seeks to censor. What it cannot regulate, it seeks to ban. Rapture was founded on an idea, and here they are held inviolate.
Interesting.
Now Tannenbaum would have you turn that sister human again. You'll get just enough Adam for our purposes, and the girls will likely try to repay you somehow. But Rapture's a high-stakes town, son, and she is a jackpot. You just have to be willing to take it all. You'll harvest more Adam than the price of one plasmid, so the rest is gravy. Think about it. Down here, it's your survival or hers.
Man, shut the fuck up. Oh shit. Oh fuck. Fuck.
Jordan,
Bertie. Shit, fuck ass. Fuck. Wallet full. First of all, this thing got a wallet? My goodness, why does shit gotta be so far away? Bringing a little sister to a vent allows you to choose whether to rescue or harvest her. If you harvest her, you get maximum item and spend on plasmids, but she will not survive the process. If you rescue her, you get less Adam, but the girl will be cured. Of course I'm rescuing her ass. We ain't evil. We got spirits. We got souls. Yes. Yes.
Well, our tin man had a heart all along. Personally, I call that a liability. But you have enough Adam now. Barely.
Fuck out of here, Sinclair.
Into the hall of the future and splice up with Incinerate.
Sinclair, a slimy nigga, I can tell. You know, since I basically got too much money right now. Yeah, Sinclair, slimy nigga for real. It's your survival. Yes, bitch, I know it's my survival. I'm surviving just fine. Thank you. Oh, what the fuck was that? Yep. Yep. Of course I say I'm surviving just fine and then get murked off. Said I'm surviving just fine, die. Oh!
What's that?
She caught me a little off guard. Man, how could I increase my health? These niggas are fucking me up. Step out of bitch. Niggas at the draft said, oh, man, we see you got a happy family. That's nice, man. That's nice. Yeah, we gonna need your youngest son, though. Yeah, we gonna need him.
And the lamb. The lamb will show us the way.
Yeah. Yeah, gonna show us the way. Yep. What you got for us? I go with that rivet gun. You have the rivet gun way more than, well, from what it looks like anything else.
I met with Sinclair today of Sinclair Solutions. It's this pseudo-legal firm he set up to take problems Ryan doesn't want to admit he has and make them go away. I could fill 40 front pages of the Tribune with stories about this fella. Not to. And he's got work for me, right? I ask what? And he flashes me these $1,000 Steinman teeth saying this job will, quote, change history.
Fuck. That shit. Can you kindly get the fuck out of the way?
Gotta stash myself.
Good looking out. You still alive? Not anymore. I was so close to fucking that up. Well, let's get a move on here. I've spent too much time in here looking for this, well, not really looking, just, you know, trying to... Oh, I did not see that.
I know this facility is vital to the preservation of secrecy and rapture, but seeing myself transformed into that lurching, waxen nightmare, do children truly respond to this? Still, I spoke to a young man exiting the park at the grand opening, asking him what, if anything, he had learned here. He said his chores didn't seem so bad anymore, as long as Mother wouldn't send him to the service.
These things be coming out the woodwork to kill you. But I almost missed this. What you got for me? I'm kind of a weak ass tonic, but I'll take it. Better than nothing. And I'm drunk now.
I've got a little dating tip for you, Jimbo. It'll get you out of that lonely hearts club for good. This scheme works 100% of the time, guaranteed. First, find some Betty and take her to Ryan Amusements. Then, you go to the gift shop, buy her a teddy bear. This is key. I ain't kidding around. Then, you buy her a ticket on Journey to the Surface. As soon as you hit that first scare, bingo! Tunnel of Love.
That's real slick, man. That's real slick.
So, you would drain the people of their life's blood. Rapture is a body, Delta. I am the voice, and Big Sister is the hand. When Rapture speaks of you, it says only this.
Yeah, I'm sorry I had to interrupt you.
Light up enemies to 1,000 degrees. Warning, fire spread.
Fireman, fireman.
Sleep now. Your day is done.
Bitch, nobody is scared of your ass.
Oh, a party. But this party just hit the skids. Carl needs a light for his cigar, and no one can help him.
Y'all hear sending your goons after people. Shit. Oh!
Holy Moses, son. Not even a big sister can keep you down. Well, come on back and melt the ice, and we can say goodbye to this two-bit carny ride.
I don't know if I say she can't keep me down. I took damn near all my health kits. She was on the verge. She was definitely on the verge.
I love the kids in Ms. Englert's third grade class, but boy, I had no idea what I was getting into. Volunteering to chaperone this New Year's sleepover party at Ryan Amusements. Donnie, get down off that exhibit, and I told you, spit out that gum! You'll choke! The kids' parents deserve a night off to enjoy New Year's, but I'm at my wit's end. Donnie, I told you!
Duty to increase the common joy. Ease the common pain. Alone, we are nothing. Mere engines of self-interest. Together, we are the family. And through unity, we transcend the self.
Y'all remember that damn lie your parents told you, saying if you chew on, if you swallow gum, you'll, that shit'll be stuck in your stomach for like 7 years, some shit like that. Parents used to love to finesse people. Now, right now, I'm looking, there's some place that has some ice on it that was over here. Or somewhere around here. I'm looking for it so I can try to get in there, but I don't know where it was.
Ryan was wrong. To hand sufficient power to any individual is to create a tyrant. We must therefore eradicate tyranny at the genetic level. To end sin itself. That is the family. That is our cause.
That's what's up, man. I don't give a damn, though. Niggas like my old shit. Buy my old album. Maybe it was over here? Man, I know it went down there. I just went back the way I came. Yeah, that's probably where it is. Hopefully. Tired of looking for it anyway.
Ryan saw the individual as a hero, a noble survivor. And Rapture was his paradise, a shrine to the supremacy of the self.
Where are we?
Slavery, genocide. Chaos. Now that the tyrant is dead, we are a true collective, a single family.
Bitch, we ain't no family. Oh, man. Shit, I was just thinking. For a damn big daddy, this nigga cannot handle his liquor. I mean, then again, if he was drinking whole bottles, yeah, it'd be understandable.
He's gone. James was the only man I ever loved, and now it's like he never even came to Rapture. He heard me sing at the limbo room, came up all bashful. He liked hearing songs about what it's really like to live in this town. I think he's been trying to organize folks against Ryan. And now he's gone. And I'm here, singing Rise, Rapture, Rise. Scared to death they're gonna come for me.
I mean, I forgot how race relations was in Rapture, but in the regular world, it's what, 1960? That ain't a good time to be black.
Outstanding, sport. You're proving to be quite a windfall.
Yeah, yeah, shut the
fuck
up.
Now just open the train tunnel from the security booth there, and I'll come out and jump on.
I don't know why. I'm being a little hostile towards this dude. I feel like he's gonna betray us at some point. No, it just wouldn't be Bioshock without some nigga, but okay, can't go out there.
I like to look a man in the eye when I give him my word. You and me, kid, we're going places.
I had thought you some golem of Sinclair's, brought here to hold Rapture's arms while he rifles through her pockets. But no, you are aware of your plight. Who, I wonder, would be so cruel to force a mirror on a man with no face?
Lem was waiting for us. Come out shooting and start the train.
Bastard. Thank you for coming.
Oh wow, they really out there, huh? Warning, you're about to leave this level. Make sure you... Yeah, I've done everything. Probably. Hopefully. I'm trying to remember the power to the people upgrade station was in Bioshock, the original one, or if it was a new one, this one. I think it was in the original one. Yeah, because I remember you could upgrade the pistol. Man, what the fuck is that? What the hell?
Subject Delta is now trapped in Pauper's Drop. All railcar travel is suspended until he is found. Remember, the enemy is alone. We are the family.
Man, nobody care about your family bullshit.
Lab's trying to box us in, kid. This is a goddamn city-wide lockdown. To keep the train moving, you need the security override key from the local governor, Grace Holloway. She kicked me out of my own hotel down here, the Sinclair Deluxe. Find her and get that key.
Damn, he was salty about getting kicked out of his hotel. I don't blame him. But, anyway. This is probably it for this episode. Thank you guys for watching. Hope y'all enjoyed it. You know, if there's anything you think that I could have done better, you know, maybe not pausing so many times. And when I say pause, I mean not speaking as much. You know, I'd be getting focused sometimes, man. But anyway, that's it for this episode. I'll catch y'all next time. Peace.